also international agencies have been overwhelming. Coordinating this have not been easy, but I'm very happy to report that things are moving very, very fast. And let us pray that we get some more positive results in the near future. But at the same time, I would like to make a plea, especially to the media and the public at large, not to spread and disseminate unverified and false news for two reasons. One, because it affects our exercise of search and rescue, because unverified news or false news will distract us from work at hand. And secondly, to be fair to the families who are hoping against hope, I do not want them to receive news that are irresponsible, news that have not been verified, and worse still, false information. That is a plea on behalf of the family, and it is a plea on behalf of those involved in the operations. Finally, I'd like to state again that we have nothing to hide. These constant PCs that we are giving is really to update whatever developments that we have, though incremental, but I believe that it is important for me to keep you guys informed. Any questions?
Can you confirm that because the Civil Aviation Authority of Vietnam has requested Malaysia has requested the Civil Aviation Authority of Vietnam to look at what object that seems to be a lifeboat 140 km southwest of Ho Chi Minh, and this was apparently spotted by Singapore.
Yes, there was a report today we just received that an aircraft sees something like an inverted life raft. So we are contacting our counterpart. We are sending ships there to verify the object, the parts. At the moment, we have not received any report on the matter. So we are still waiting for the report.
Sir, when you said that you were Charmaine Gracias of NHK, you said that when you were coordinating with the Chinese delegation on possibly identifying those who used false passports, does this mean to say that they are Chinese?
No.
Daripada RM itu, kenaan perbincangan dan pertemuan dengan agen China pagi tadi, ada tak perbincangkan mengenai laporan bahawa kumpulan dari China mengaku tanggungjawab menghubung kehilangan pesawat itu dan kaitannya dengan dua pasport yang
tidak ada, dan dia bukan agent. Sebenarnya mereka merupakan wakil daripada kementerian-kementerian yang merupakan berkepentingan di China, dan juga daripada parti. Dan ini hasil daripada perbincangan kedua-dua Perdana Menteri China dan Malaysia 2 hari lepas pukul 6, dan perbincangan saya dengan beberapa pemimpin China malam semalam. Yes. Lady in front.
Sir Evelyn from Reuters, yes, the reports that China was a little unhappy about your investigation so far, do you have any comment on that?
Far from it. I've had a very long discussion with a number of leaders from the Chinese party and also from the ministries last night. And in fact, far from it. The ambassador has been making a lot of very positive statements, and he's been seeing firsthand what we have been doing. And basically, the task force is here really to assist at my request. Yes, over there.
I just would like to ask if
there
is an update about the passport, the two passports,
yes.
Italian and Australian.
Yes.
The real one was in Wolf Party. Why the fake one was able to use this time? Wasn't there any data limit?
I have been meeting up with the intelligence agencies, met up with the U.S. Intelligence yesterday. Today we've shared the information, both the biometric and the background information and the visuals that have been recorded in KLIA. And those information are now being digested by the relevant agencies, both local and international. So until we get more information, I will that because I do not want information that we reveal today will, to affect the ongoing investigation by those agencies. Yeah.
There is this group called China Martyrs Brigade taking responsibilities. Open letters were sent to the media in China. What are the stance on this? Are we taking investigations seriously?
We investigate all allegations, but like I said, our focus is really to locate the aircraft. And basically, all this information with the agencies that are working with us, this sort of information we can relay to the relevant agencies to get confirmation. I just do not want to be distracted, as I appealed to everybody earlier, that unverified or false information will distract not only the ongoing operations, but it also affects the family members, and I think that is not fair.
Have you already seen the open letter?
Yes, and I don't think there is any sound ground to say it is true. But again, like I said, we have taken a stand from the beginning that we are not taking anything for granted.
Yeah. Any updates on the whales leak?
No.
Ada pagi tadi, Pisti pagi tadi mengatakan pihak berkuasa akan bilang petunjuk dan ada petunjuk baru untuk mengesat bilangan pesawat. Adakah dengan pertemuan dengan delegasi dari China ni mendapat petunjuk baru?
Dengan China kita berhubung daripada awal lagi. Tapi sekarang ni ada satu pasukan khas yang ditempatkan di sini untuk membantu kita dalam tiga perkara yang saya sebutkan awal tadi. Dan tiga perkara itulah yang merupakan sesuatu yang saya akan tekankan dan memberi fokus. Kerana tidak ada gunanya kita bincang perkara-perkara lain kalau sekiranya pesawat itu tak dapat dikesan.
Ramai.
Yeah.
TV,
yes, hi.
Ask about does you say that the Chinese government is taking over everything?
No. Well, far from it. In fact, they made a point today in our meetings with the relevant agencies, whether it's with MAS, whether it's with DCA, whether it's PLIA, or with our intelligence agencies and the military. They said that they're here only to assist. And I appreciate that because of our strong relationship that we have, not only with China, but with the US yesterday. And as you know, Singapore and Australia has deployed assets, and I'm pleased to inform you that even New Zealand today have come on board with deploying one another Orion. So we have now four P3 Orions in the vicinity.